The Eastern Economic Corridor, also known as the EEC, which is probably an alliteration that was named after the sound environmentalists made when they read it, because eek. So anyways, it's no secret that Thailand's economy is hugely successful right now, and this Eastern Economic Corridor is definitely not going to hurt. The NLA voted overwhelmingly to accept this new legislation because, well, the NLA will support almost anything as long as it doesn't interfere with election interference. Yes, the Thai government wants to build a road to anywhere except democracy. So first, what is this new legislation? Now, as you can imagine, improving a major part of your country's infrastructure isn't free. The bill that passed predicted the whole project would cost about 1.5 trillion Thai baht, or over $43 billion over the next 5 years. Most people, I imagine, are probably not sure whether this is a number or not. Sip your drink in peace, because this number, while large, doesn't seem to cross the line into US defense spending levels of ridiculousness. That said, it still does beg the question of financing, because when you look into government plans, they seem to seldom include spending their own money on projects. In this case, the money will come from a mix of state funds, public-private partnerships, and foreign direct investments. Alright, so that's a lot of words to just drop on someone, and I imagine that some of your eyes glazed over more than Trump's when he inevitably walks the aisles of his presidential library. Oh man, we'll finally have an answer to the question, how many unsold copies of The Art of the Deal and Ivanka Trump memoirs can you cram into one building? So, what do these methods of financing entail? Well, first we have the state funds, which is pretty cut and dry. That's the taxpayer money portion. Next, we go to the fun one, encouraging foreign direct investment. This has already caused the world's largest petrol company, PTT Global, to announce that they're opening a $985 million plant because of these tax cuts, as well as an already $9.3 billion invested by private industry, according to Thailand's investment agency. This is really great for Thailand, especially considering the caliber of private investment they seem to be inspiring. I mean, we're not talking Joe's T-shirt Emporium, but more on the level of Saab Aerospace Research. A potential drawback to these funds is that these are foreign direct investments, meaning that the tax breaks are largely going to helping the bottom line of a foreign country's corporation, which is about as useful to the Thai government as the British royal wedding was to my personal life. That said, Thailand will benefit because a side effect of that growth is Thai employment and infrastructure investment are growing as well. The other type of funding to look out for is public-private partnerships, which, thank you for making that a fun little alliteration for all of us researchers out there. There are currently 7 public-private partnerships available, and they make up the majority of projects that we talk about when we talk about the EEC. These are, as the name would suggest, partially funded by the state funds mentioned above, and partially funded by private industries. The latest numbers published by the International Lawyers Kingdom of Thailand say that 30% of the funding for these projects will come from the government, while 59% will come from private industry, and 10% will come from state-owned companies. And somehow, the Royal Thai Army got duped into putting up exactly 1% of the funds. You know you're really helping when your contribution could be mistaken for a rounding error. Anyways, this leads us to the obvious question that I don't want people to think I'm evil for asking, but why would a corporation want to contribute to something for the public good? I mean, that's about as good for the bottom line as a Thai street vendor selling real Rolexes. Well, the incentive lies in the fact that once the construction is done, the private industry will be able to receive the operating costs of the project, and to that point, probably ensure that the project will make a profit by charging you for everything they can get away with. So what are these projects? Well, the main one we see is we have a high-speed railway connecting 3 airports in Bangkok, Pattaya, and Makassan that's expected to cost 200 billion baht, or $6.4 billion. Wow, it sounds so much more dramatic in baht! In my opinion, this is where it gets interesting though. because in order to attract private investment, they have already announced the fare prices for different routes, as well as the private sector value of 400 billion baht over the next 50 years. Wow, you're planning this one out 50 years out? I haven't seen that much faith in railroads since the early 19th century. Don't worry though, I'm not going to go point by point down each investment opportunity in detail. I'm not going to timeshare salesman into putting your money into a Thai airport. So this plan sounds pretty much perfect, but what are the problems? Well, two major ones. First, we have the environment. Yes, the darn environment, the negative to seemingly every quick fix solution. As an American, I can hardly imagine this being a problem, but the Thai government is being too efficient and doing more fast-tracking than a bullet train. One concern is that they've shortened the period for environmental and health impact assessments for their projects to 120 days. Now some people might think, well, I could write a novel-sized report if you gave me 4 months, but it's a very limited amount of time for making not only assessments, but also suggestions for projects. Plus, with the government funding things like a Silicon Valley venture capitalist who just took a hit of cocaine, most people allege that these important reports are more of a formality than an actual respected part of the project. Now, another problem is exacerbating pre-existing problems in the eastern region of Thailand. One example is a region that is undergoing intense development, while the existing petrochemical industry is still occasionally leaking.
In the last year alone, there's been more than 100 funerals for villagers who died from cancer and rare respiratory illnesses in Maptiput District. And, according to the Eastern People's Network, which is fighting to halt further industrial expansion, many more undiagnosed deaths were transferred out of the province.
The real worry here is that, in continuing to industrialize that region, even if you do everything right, the buffer zones between those leaking and polluting plants will be sold to residential developers. And you can guess what happens from there. However, the EEC secretary quickly responded by saying that the 10 industries promoted by the Eastern Economic Corridor are clean and environmental, and more steps would be taken to clean up the existing environmental hazards. But the tendency is to think that he is more full of crap than the air around Maptiput District. Now, there's one other interesting concern associated with the EEC. You're gentrifying entire regions of Thailand. The potential growth in these rural regions of Thailand are in robotics, aerospace, aviation, and automation industries. And unfortunately, none of those industries bring many jobs for people whose entire resume can be summed up in having worked in the same farm for the last 30 years. While the prospects for these rural inhabitants are already dim, this development in their neighborhoods is making them not be able to afford the land anymore. That said, don't worry, foreigners have a long history of respecting the indigenous populations while pursuing their industrial ambitions. Overall though, this seems to be a good move that will help the majority of Thailand, but not without its drawbacks. Thank you, and that's all I have to say about that. Hey YouTube, I have a LINE account and my ID is Person of Interest 101. My QR code is right here. So feel free to reach out to me if you have any suggestions for future episodes. Make sure you to remember to subscribe by clicking here and checking out some of my previous episodes of Thai Thursday by clicking here. Now this development project was a part of the Thai 4.0 initiative, something that I summarize in this video right here. So thank you for watching.